Meantime, more rising tension is looming farther east with China as President Obama prepares for a second term. A new report suggests China is just 2 years away from deploying nuclear ballistic missiles on its submarines, missiles with a 4,600-mile range.
Joseph Farah is the founder of WorldNet Daily. According to Joseph Farah's G2 Bulletin, in an article dated November 19, 2010, experts are now saying that the mystery contrail off the California coast last week was from a Chinese missile. And of all things, that the muted response thus far was a decision made by the president himself. And that U.S. Navy anti-submarine warfare sensors apparently failed again. And on top of this, experts are speculating that the Pentagon is working with the media to orchestrate a cover-up of the entire affair. Farah's report says this, that the U.S. Defense Department and North American Aerospace Defense Command have speculated publicly that the unidentified contrail of a projectile simply came from a jet airplane and posed no security threat to the United States. But, Farah reports, several experts are now raising provocative and disturbing questions about the government's official response. Two governmental military experts with extensive experience working with missiles and computer security systems have examined the television video and conclude that the mysterious contrail originating some 30 miles off the coast near Los Angeles did not come from a jet airliner. But rather, they say, the exhaust and the billowing plume emanated from a single-source nozzle of a missile, probably made in China. They further suggest the missile was fired from a submerged Chinese nuclear submarine off America's coast, and point out that the timing of the alleged Chinese missile shot coincided with an increasing confrontation between the U.S. and China, and was likely meant to send a message to Washington. Indeed, the Federal Aviation Administration documents that there were no aircraft flying in the area at that time, the night of November the 8th, Farah's report says.
Missiles with a 4,600-mile range.
Furthermore, U.S. Navy officials confirm a Russian nuclear-powered attack submarine was detected 300 miles off the east coast of the United States in late October. Russia's Navy commander announced earlier this year that on June 1st, Russian nuclear-powered subs would return to patrolling the world's oceans as they did during the Soviet time spread.
With a 4,600-mile range.
The United States is the most powerful nation in the world, and we're not going to be intimidated by Russia and China. We are not. So I guarantee you that they will not act. If we launch these strikes against Syria, they will not act.
The right to a preemptive nuclear strike against China is now part of U.S. law. That's thanks to the National Defense Authorization Act. The Pentagon's also ordered a thorough review of when and how the U.S. could strike at the network of tunnels believed to hold Beijing's atomic arsenals. The U.S. government is operating on the assumption that there are 3,000 miles worth of tunnels crisscrossing China, allegedly containing 3,000 nuclear warheads.
U.S. intelligence estimates puts the Chinese nuclear arsenal something like 300. But this study out of Georgetown in 2011 estimated that it could house as many as 3,000 nuclear warheads.
Certainly at this point, though, we've been getting reports that there have been some rather peculiar high-altitude jet forays between China and Japan. Some Japanese jets tailing Chinese jets, basically playing some high-altitude games of cat and mouse, possibly reigniting another territorial dispute. They've been having disputes for quite some time now.
Hi, everybody. Today is November 29th, 2013. Just coming in, how China has sent, again, for the second time, more planes over this disputed area, and it says here that they chased U.S.-Japanese planes in this disputed zone. Chinese defense authorities say they sent more fighter jets to the newly declared air defense zone in the East China Sea on Friday. Today, this is the second day Beijing is deploying its aircraft to the controversial zone. The Chinese Air Force described the mission as defensive measure in line with international law. Beijing also says the country's air force will remain on high alert and take measures to deal with all air threats to protect China's national security. The Chinese Air Force spokesman, Colonel Shen Jing, said Chinese warplanes have been scrambled to identify U.S. surveillance aircraft and several Japanese planes crossing through the zone. Last week, the country announced that foreign aircraft passing through the airspace, including passenger planes, will have to identify themselves to Chinese authorities. In defiance of Beijing's move, Japan and South Korea also flew military aircraft through the zone on Thursday, while Washington sent two unarmed bombers into the airspace earlier this week. None of those aircraft informed Beijing.
This is Dabu 7, and you're watching AMTV, Alternative Media Television. Taking a look at China, they have came out through their state-run media and revealed for the first time this week that Beijing's nuclear submarines can and will attack American cities as a means to counterbalance the U.S. nuclear deterrence in the Pacific. Now, they have come out and made some bold statements, and there's also a map. This is the Washington Times, and this is the Extinction Protocol. I'll leave links for both. But they come out and they state that they will fire these missiles over the North Pole, and estimated that only one single Type 94 can kill and wound 5 million to 12 million Americans, the Global Times reported. Now, they also have land-based intercontinental ballistic missiles, and they also say that they can launch them over the North Pole and can easily destroy a whole list of cities: Annapolis, Philly, New York, Boston, Portland, Baltimore, all in the New England area. And because the Midwest is so sparsely populated, they would not hit it. They would go for the West Coast. You're talking Los Angeles, Seattle, San Francisco, San Diego. This is what their state-run television is showing the people. These are the cities that they would hit right here. So this is what China's saying. This is where they will hit if it comes down to it. So you can never say that they never told you so. I'm sure that they have other targets in mind if they were to do so as well, but as of right now, there's their key targets. I'll leave links as always. Thanks for watching AMTV, Alternative Media Television.
We're not gonna make it, are we? People, I mean.
It's in your nature to destroy yourselves.
Yeah. Major drag, huh?
winning mood is not to play. The only winning mood is not to play.